Good morning, my darlings, and welcome to Vlogmas day 24. Can you believe we made it? We vlogged every single day throughout December up to Christmas, and what a fantastic Vlogmas it has been. I just want to start this vlog by saying I am so very grateful for all of you guys for watching. I feel like it's been the best Vlogmas ever, dare I say it, but it's all thanks to you guys, so thank you so much for everybody that has watched the videos. Of course, you guys will be watching this on Christmas Day, so Merry Christmas. I would love to know, let me know down below when you're watching, because I know that so many people don't watch on Christmas Day. They wait, they enjoy it in the Christmas crimbo limbo. Let me know also where you are. Are you at home? Are you lounging around? Have you just had a Christmas dinner? Have you just eaten your leftovers? Let me know in the comment section down below. And while you are there, let me know what has been your favorite Vlogmas memory from 2022. Was it the festive mac and cheese and the gingerbread defender? Gift wrapping? There have been so many fun things going on. So let me know what you enjoyed the most. Now, darlings, I'm actually filming this on the 23rd. So you have another bumper 2-day vlog in store for you today. I'm gonna film a few clips tomorrow on Christmas Eve. It's gonna be a lot of food prep, a lot of busying about. This morning has been a busy morning. I've been out to do the recycling. I've been and done a food shop. I have done a little bit of kitchen cleaning. What else have I done? Collected the ice, got the car washed. And now all dressed up, ready to head to Lord of the Manor in Lower Slaughter for our festive afternoon tea. So darlings, we're gonna hit the road. I've gone blurry again. My camera's like, we're coming to the end and I'm about to give up. But darlings, for the last time for Vlogmas 2022, please enjoy the Vlogmas intro. Lovely Lords of the Manor Hotel. It's a very typical Cotswold building. You might remember last time we came here, there was a gorgeous floral archway here. We had afternoon tea on the lawn with Charlie's family friends, whose father actually used to run this hotel. Shout out to Richard Young. And yeah, it's looking a little bit more bleak this time, but very festive, and we are heading through for afternoon tea. My darlings, we are back home again. It's only 5 o'clock, but it feels so much later. We had a lovely afternoon tea, feeling wonderfully full from lots of sandwiches and sweet treats. We still have ended up with a box full of the sweet bits because we could not polish it all off, but yeah, it's really, really lovely. A very traditional afternoon tea. So now Charlie and I, well, actually we've just been dashing around the house getting all the bedrooms ready. Charlie's mum and dad, brother, sister, and almost sister-in-law are arriving tomorrow lunchtime, so we've just been putting the towels in the bedrooms. I've been putting the little gifts in the bedrooms, and just generally that last minute dash around the house dash is what we're getting on with tonight. I also have got a little tray of leftover cookies, leftover gingerbread pieces. I mostly used any leftover gingerbread when I was rolling it out for the defender to do these little Christmas trees, and also to practice my icing. So I thought I would just make them look a little bit prettier. And I also had an idea, because we have
got my brother a TV for his Christmas gift, so I thought I would make this bit here look like a TV and wrap that up so that he can, you know, have something in his stocking. And Charlie picked up all of these cake making bits from Waitrose earlier, so I'm gonna do a little bit of quick decorating while I catch up on some people's Vlogmases, and then I think Charlie has got a full to-do list for us to crack on with this evening. The Christmas Eve lasagna table. It's going to be 8 of us tomorrow evening. I have received this lovely unexpected delivery from Margaret Dabbs, and it is her collection of luxury crackers. So I thought I would spread these out on the table for our Christmas Eve dinner. I think they've got some lovely pampering bits inside, so that'll be lovely for everyone to enjoy over the Christmas period. I've got the flower arrangements up on the sink there. I think Charlie wants to give them a mist so that they stay nice and fresh for the time that they need to look good on the table. I'm trying to think what else I need to do. I have prepared the napkins for Christmas Day breakfast, and the next thing on my to-do list is to prepare the napkins for our Christmas Day lunch. Well, my darlings, it's now 9 p.m. We have done a little last minute dash of gift wrapping, and we are now about to watch the second Downton Abbey film. Can you believe, for such hardcore Downton Abbey fans as Charlie and I, that we still to this day have not seen the second film, and we are going to have a nice pizza. I think we're just going to share a pizza because we're still, well, we're only just becoming hungry now after our big afternoon tea. So I'm going to take my makeup off. I'm going to pop one of the Beauty Pie blemish patches on my little spot. It has gone down quite a lot, but I'd like it to be completely vanished for tomorrow. So tomorrow morning, which will of course be in this vlog, we're gonna do, I think we have 4 days to catch up on my advent calendar, and then it's gonna be a lot of food prep. I might have to do a dash to Daylesford or a bakery to get some baguettes for our garlic bread. But yeah, tomorrow's the big pre-day. So darlings, I will see you in the morning. Good morning, my darlings. It is Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas. It feels very festive today. It's cold, it's frosty, it's blue skies. Not that you can see any of that from the through the car window. I have got a car full of recycling, Funorama, and I'm heading, oh, I need to make this seat a bit higher. I have not driven this car in quite some time. But I don't like to take my car to the recycling centre, so I've got that fun job this morning, and I've got to go and get a few fresh bits from Daylesford, some bread, some eggs, some soup for lunch, and then it's back for a full day of food prep with Charlie on Christmas Eve. Normally my entire job on Christmas Eve is just to make Charlie's day easier, essentially. I've realised that that is the smoothest way to do things. So that's chopping veg, doing the washing up,
doing any little errands. I feel like earlier in the week we got most of the house stuff done. I don't really have that much else on my to-do list. I'm currently marinating in fake tan, so I'll have a quick shower, wash that off, and pop my hair in rollers when I get back. But yes, it's gonna be a busy morning. So without further ado, let's get down to Daylesford. Oh my goodness, you guys. I am such a softie. I don't know what it is, but when I drive, I just get very emotional, and I've had the speakers in this car are really, really good, and I've just had the Christmas at Downton Abbey Christmas suite playlist going, and I've cried twice on this car journey. There's something about Christmas that just makes me very emotional. Tchaikovsky's Nutcracker came on and I'm literally blasting the speakers, and it is such a beautiful piece of music, and my eyes, I could cry again now, and this is just me being a total softie. My eyes were properly welling up and I almost had to pull over because I could barely see. And I was just thinking, firstly, what a beautiful piece of music. Secondly, imagine being the ballerina. What am I like? Imagine being the ballerina at the top of your career performing to that bit of music. Like, how incredible that feeling must be. And also think about how proud you would be as a parent if your child was dancing to the Nutcracker. And then Joy to the World came on when I was driving down the most beautiful bit of road, and the sun was coming through the trees, and I just felt so grateful to live here and so grateful for everything. So yeah. Oh my gosh, I need to pull myself together. I am a festive emotional mess. Anyway, yeah, I'm just very, very grateful for everything. Thank you guys for being here. Thank you for watching these videos. Right, now I need to go and buy some bread and eggs.
Wouldn't really be the last day of Vlogmas without a trip to Daylesford.
I have just had the best idea in the entire world, literally the best idea, and I would like to run it past you. So driving through the lanes just now, obviously again just blasting my favourite Christmas songs, almost breaking the speakers, singing at the top of my lungs, and I was thinking, how fun would it be if we all had a Christmas carol sing-along in our church here in the Cotswolds next year? Like, imagine we all get dressed up like in fabulous outfits, beautiful fluffy coats because it's blooming freezing in that church. I'll organize amazing flowers all through the church. I'll organize a choir. I'll organize a traditional band, and we'll all just get together, drink mulled wine, and have a Christmas carol service. Like, how epic would that be? Let me know what you think to that idea, if you would come, and if you would be willing to buy tickets, which would obviously be for charity. Like, how fun for us all to get together, celebrate the joy of Christmas, the joy of Vlogmas, and just have a festive sing-song. And we could do a mix of traditional, like, hark now, hear the angels sing. I can't sing. And then we could do some really fun ones, like Feliz Navidad. I just think that would be so fun. I obviously need to persuade Charlie because he's like, Christmas is stressful enough. But our church is so beautiful, and I've actually never been to like a proper traditional carol service, but we could make it just so fun. Don't you think that would be amazing? And we could potentially make loads of money for charity as well. So yeah, let me know what you think to that idea. And it would probably be like the second week of December, so it's not too close. And you could make a whole Cotswold weekend out of it. How fun. Anyway, home again. I'll drop that idea on Charlie a little bit later. And now it's time to get seriously busy. I am on veg chopping duty for the lasagna later tonight. Family are arriving. It's 11 a.m. now, 12:12. Family are arriving in 3 hours, so it's time to get busy. Oh, you're lovely. Spinning!
Where's the spinny one? There he is!
And an ear flop. An ear flop for good measure.
Daddy, this is the best day ever. I love getting treats. I love Christmas treats. Okay, darlings, here he is, the busiest man in the world on Christmas Eve. So, what is on the agenda today?
The agenda is, I'm ticking off all the easy jobs first.
Uh-huh.
So, I just thought I'd get all the fresh orange juice.
Easy made. Squeezy.
Easy squeezy, lemon peasy.
Peasy.
I'm just doing orange juice. Fresh orange juice makes a big difference. We're going to have this with our brunch tomorrow.
Fabulous.
Christmas, tomorrow being Christmas Day.
Are we going to do a Bucks Fizz?
Yeah, we're going to do Bucks Fizz. Obviously, I'll just have orange juice. Breakfast. If there's any left over, we'll have it on Boxing Day, but I'm not putting pressure on that. We've got lots of fresh apple juice for Boxing Day.
Mm-hmm.
And then, so I'm going to do that. Then I'm going to get the turkey prepared.
So we're going to
make the sausage meat. So you mix the sausage meat, we'll go through that in a minute.
Can I request that it's not too sausagey? Because last year I found the stuffing a bit too sausagey.
We're doing what we're doing. and then I'll do a tray of it so we can have a spare tray. There's only eight of us.
A slightly less sausagey tray.
Yeah, of stuffing. And then what we're doing?
Chopping the veg for the lasagne?
Yeah, then basically you're going to be on lasagna duty.
Yep.
While I focus on getting a few other things ticked off. So I'll get the carrots and parsnips prepared.
Yep.
We will get the gravy made,
mm-hmm.
We'll get the Yorkshire batter for Boxing Day made, just mm-hmm. because we might as well get that done as well.
Yep.
And I might even try and do the red wine jus for Boxing Day now as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we get all the sort of messy, take a lot of pan job done, out the way.
Mm-hmm.
And then the only things tomorrow being Christmas Day I'll do, aside from putting things to cook, I'll do the broccoli and cauliflower cheese tomorrow because I think
some people
prep it, but it's much better fresh. But we'll prepare the breadcrumbs for that as well, which are a slightly different breadcrumb mix because we'll have almonds in there.
And aren't we doing some of the garlic bread?
I don't know. We'll see what we think on that. We could do. Depends on what's left over.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll do the roast. Roasties are done tomorrow. George will peel them in the morning with me. The only thing that I always I forget is how early I have to get up. So tomorrow, because it's only eight of us, but the turkey's 7.5 kilograms, and we want to eat at 3:30, really.
Mm-hmm.
I have to get up at 7 because I have to get the bird out.
Can I have a look?
Yeah, it needs to be out 2 hours before we cook it.
What are they saying, Gavin and Stacey?
This is the smallest one we've had in a while. Lovely.
Oh, she's a beaut.
Yeah. So there you go. You've got the giblets.
Giblets. Lovely.
Gravy.
That's good that they get them out for you.
Yeah. So
that's a grim job.
Yeah, so we'll get that all prepared, and it's quite special, isn't it? There's part of me that doesn't, go OTT, I'm not obsessed with turkey, and also something quite nice about having it at Christmas, because it's the only time
it's the tradition,
have. So yeah, that'll get prepped up.
Fabulous.
About beef wellingtons on Boxing Day.
Yes.
There we go.
I was going to ask you, for Christmas Day lunch, are we having steak knives or regular knives?
Steak knives.
Okay.
Because those bone-handled steak knives are sharp, and I always think you want a sharp knife when you use it when you're eating like turkey.
Do you know what's not sharp?
I'm not too sharp, mummy.
Oh,
do you know what? I'm very
excited
to see my Auntie Scarlett.
I can't wait to see Auntie Scarlett. I've got my Christmas sausages already. Oh, Dexy never. Dexy always has to be front and center.
I cannot miss out on footage.
If there's a true star of Vlogmas this year, it's definitely us, because we're just the loveliest sausage dogs in the whole world. Oh, we're so lovely. 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 Plenty.
But we could potentially grate some cheeses for various things.
That's a great idea.
Because the cauliflower cheese, I want Gruyere in it. Alexa, volume up.
Hello, my Chick-fil-A. Hello, my Chick-fil-A. I like to sit here where it's very, very warm. I like to sit here where it's very, very warm.
Okay, my darlings. This is very exciting. The final advent calendar of Vlogmas 2023. You can, but it's been fun, hasn't it, darling?
It has, although next year I would quite like it if we're doing one a day, because you've got four today.
Four?
Yeah.
Very exciting, so I'm going to hand you the camera.
You've stockpiled four up, so if you work your way back from 24th, so 24, 23, 22, 21, so start with 21.
21, right, okay. Ein und zwanzig.
Okay, good German.
Can you speak German? Sprechen Sie Deutsch? Yeah.
No.
I'm in a really weird mood today.
Yeah.
A window cleaner's worst nightmare. Is it a cracked window or is it dicky?
Why is Dickie a window cleaner's worst nightmare?
It goes like this.
Oh, yeah, true.
Or is it my Velux? Have you put it on my Velux?
Velux, but no.
A window cleaner's worst nightmare.
I mean, some of these hiding places have already been done before, because obviously 24 hiding places is not that straightforward.
If I was a window... I mean, this one...
What's a lot of work for a window cleaner?
Oh, greenhouse!
Yeah, okay.
Woo! Okay. Right.
Someone, inside and out.
Someone sent me a photo of a greenhouse gingerbread house.
That's cool, but we won't be doing that next year. For those on the YouTube, Josie has spent, albeit a whole week, and it looks great, but it was so time consuming. Meanwhile, I've been running around getting the house ready.
It's not like I've been sat on my butter.
No, but you've been making a flipping gingerbread fender. And what's gingerbread going to be like 10 days after you made it? Not very nice.
Eating, it's for admiring.
Oh, for goodness sake.
This bed was made in Plymouth. Is it the Cornish bed coming?
There you go, good. Yep. Right. I'm running out of clues.
Plymouth in Cornwall?
Yeah, I think so.
Right. Ein, zwei, drei, und zwanzig.
Is Plymouth in Devon or Cornwall? It's one of the two. 20. It's got to be Cornwall.
This room would have made an epic cinema room. Is it the Snug?
Nope.
My dressing
room. Yeah. It would have.
When we bought this house, my dressing room was labelled as a cinema room.
It was bedroom number 8, forward slash cinema room,
wasn't
it? Do you
know what? I've got a confession. When we first came to view this house, I think you were 90% sold, and I was only 70% sold, because I was like, it's so big, it's a lot. And then when I thought about turning that room into my dressing room,
well, that I think that was where people were amazed that you were happy for me to have the dressing room, which is off the bathroom, because obviously yeah. I am very lucky. My dressing room is literally right by my bedroom. But then equally, you, your space is just perfect in that it's a great filming space
one
as well.
One thing I would love to do is put a spiral staircase here, because then I could come out of our... And I still would really like to look into doing it. We need to get structural engineer over. Then I would come out of our bedroom, because this is the entrance way.
I don't believe it is, though. I think we worked out that this is in potentially in the attic bedroom. Anyway,
no,
let's move on.
We
digress.
This is literally the entrance to my dressing
Josie
room.
Josie is in an odd mood today. Let's move on.
I've been singing Christmas carols at the top of my lungs.
Okay.
Down the
it's good to be excited, but yeah, we've got lots to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
The most Christmassy room in the house, the drawing room.
Okay, so you have to do them in order, obviously. Okay. So okay. We're going outside first, I think.
Right. Get your coat on, love. You're pulled.
Oh. All right. I have no idea. You are a doorknob.
Not even that cold today, are you?
No, it's quite mild today. It's. Do you know what? As much as snow would have been lovely, for the amount of disruption it would have created for not just us, but for every family in the UK,
yeah.
I'm quite happy that we had the snow and now it's melted and...
Nasty Dixie's garden, come on, chicken.
Shout out to our amazing gardener, Jack, because she has cut loads back and made it look very pretty because the snow really did decimate a lot of the plants. But I think...
Trim your balls.
But no, we're trying to let the U balls get a bit bigger, I think. What I do love, and we've copied from time, is the sedums. We just kind of leave them. And they do look quite brown and quite sad, but I think they give a really nice structure.
I swear that bit of U has got smaller.
Maybe, I don't know. Who knows?
Right, what have we got in here? Simply, there's my bagger. Is there a gift?
Yeah. It's hanging.
Oh, it's a heart-shaped
yeah.
Oh.
Careful, it is quite sharp.
Sneebor.
Yeah, that's the... So Sneebor is the Rolls-Royce of gardening tools. They're
oh,
the ones... They're the really, really good ones.
Wow. So I can use that for...
Well, I just thought it was cute. Yeah. And obviously, I know you. We don't really need any more gardening tools, but I just thought it was a heart, it was sweet, and it looked good on your...
It's really cute.
It looks good on... This looks nice with the... I'd keep that foliage there as long as
yeah,
it can like, live
there.
Yeah,
I think it'll last for a long time.
And I think your artwork looks nice up there, doesn't it?
It does.
Do you think?
We should do something with this in the house because it's so beautiful.
I think we should also bring these pooky lights in to use in the dining room this evening.
Well, I think
especially
that's
now.
Gonna make a spray. Oh, we've still got some mistletoe. I'll bring this in the house and
okay.
A little kiss.
So there we go, little heart-shaped.
Thank you, darling.
Martin kindly drilled it for me and put
oh,
the leather in.
Cute.
So yeah, I think that looks nice there now.
It does. I will definitely get a lot of use out of that
yeah.
In the spring.
I mean, it's quite a good one for just, you know, for short potting and stuff.
I need to read that.
Oh yeah, these are your books.
I'll bring them into the house after Christmas.
I think let's grab a lamp each and let's take them in. because I think, and I'll plug them in first, because I think these will come in handy tonight.
Yeah.
Right.
Come on, Lexi.
Where are we off to now?
We are off to the top of the house for the bed that was made in Plymouth. So. Look how lovely the bed
is. It does look cute. So this is George and Petra in here. I love the new light fittings. They need patching up. But I've just become obsessed with Fomoy fabric. So these are Fomoy fabric lampshades. We love Pookie, but I just couldn't find any Pookie ones that would look good in here. You plonker. Here we go. But it's looking lovely in here. I think it feels pretty finished in here.
Yeah.
I think, obviously, one day I think a bigger bed, but you know, yeah, me and you disagree on that, don't we?
Agree to disagree. Up we go.
Okay. This bed, I believe, was made in Plymouth. Cornish Bed Company.
This bedroom looks lovely. Just shift out of the way and I can show it on the camera. It does look lovely in here, doesn't it?
I can't see my bed again.
Oh, I mean, you got to think about where things might be with a bed. Where would the monster live?
Oh, I got to go on the hands and
knees. Oh, it's the other side as well.
Oh.
Come on, fella.
Okay. The things you make me do. Oh, lish them up.
Yeah, I hope you'll use these. I just thought, yeah, the ankle ones. I just thought kept seeing them being promoted, and I just thought, you know what? You need a pair of these.
Wow.
They're not 100% pink. Woo! They're like a reddish pink.
They'll be great for gardening.
Yeah. So I thought, hopefully they fit. Otherwise, we'll obviously have to.
Lady garden, they're the charity ones. Also.
Yeah. Well, they get there for charity. Yeah.
Oh, thank you, darling. How gorgeous! I would definitely get lots of wear out of them. Perfect.
Probably beyond the return now anyway, given how long
lovely.
I've had them.
So the
you've seen this
one...
is the new book in here. I actually bought this book for you originally, and then you've got too many gifts for Christmas, so I just put it in here. Have you seen it? It's the Gardens of Babylon Storen.
That's such a good idea.
It's we're staying at the new for New Year's, aren't we?
Yep, can't wait.
Right.
Right, the next one is a window... Oh no, we've already done that one.
Yeah, so you've got two more.
We've done the window cleaner's worst nightmare. We've done the bed that was made in Plymouth. Next is this room. Was meant to be a cinema room.
Yeah.
Right, come with me.
So I hope it's tidy in there, mate.
Is this why you sent me off to Dalesford, so that you could put all these gifts everywhere?
It's not actually, but it worked quite nicely.
Okay.
Did you get any tartan paint while you were there?
Yeah, I know.
I asked you I asked you to ask for a long wait.
So, I reckon that the our bedroom, it would come up here, the spiral staircase.
Look, it maybe would. We'll have to see. But the thing that you don't quite appreciate in all of this is the fact that we have underfloor heating throughout the house. So I have no idea how that would work, and we potentially open a real can of worms because you'd have to re-divert underfloor heating.
No,
we will see. We will see.
Ooh, what have we got here? Enpeel?
Yeah, mate.
Wow.
Well, you've got to remember, for people watching this that think some of these gifts are like a bit OTT, these are essentially your birthday gifts.
Yes.
I kind of stretch your birthday gifts out.
Wow, that is stunning.
I hope, obviously I can return this. It's small, I think.
Absolutely gorgeous.
And I know it's green, but
ooh,
I thought...
I'm not wearing green.
I thought you need to wear more, really, more green.
That is gorgeous.
It is one to be...
nice crop.
Yeah. Well, it looked nice on the picture, so I think it'll look lovely on you. So there you go.
Lovely, I adore this. And then last but not least...
So hopefully you can wear that on our Boxing Day walk, maybe.
Yes, definitely.
So Enpeel Cashmere. If you're not familiar on Josie's channel, you should be, because it's a British brand. And it's British owned, British designed. The products are made abroad, because obviously you can't get proper cashmere in the UK, as we learned recently.
Actually, you learned in the very first Vlogmas.
Yeah.
Yeah. Full circle,
mate.
Full circle.
Right.
Right.
Let's turn these lights off. Save on electricity. You left your fan on in there when you went out, by the way.
I left it on auto because it's
fine. Wow, it's very, very, very hot in your dressing room. Right. Final gift.
The last of the advent calendar.
And we're off.
And the final advent of 2022.
You are lucky, because then tomorrow you get a load of gifts tomorrow for Christmas.
Yeah, we dragged my birthday out all month. So the most Christmassy room in the house is, of course, the drawing room. I expect to find a sausage dog in here.
Is he in here?
No. Oh my goodness, this is very exciting. I have to confess, I did spot.
I know you did.
In your dressing room.
I thought you did.
I really hope that's me and not a secret lover like in Love Actually.
Oh my goodness, can you imagine? Do you know what? That still keeps me, exaggeration, massive, but still keeps me awake at night. They didn't close that bit off in the film. So every other element of that film in Love Actually has a happy ending, yet that doesn't. Like, he has a sort of semi-affair, and then they just sort of deal with it.
What a tosspot.
I know, well, careful, because he's no longer with us, unfortunately. Snape, isn't it? It's the, great actor, Alan Rickman. But the character is a tosspot, yeah.
Well, this is very generous, darling.
Well.
And we're not meant to be doing big gifts for each other.
Look, well, no, but this is a birthday gift. This is a birthday gift. We're not doing big Christmas gifts.
Look at the colour of the rope and the ribbon.
I hope you like it. I'll be honest, the bit of this gift that I desperately wanted to get you, they were out of stock. So I was waiting for them to come back in stock, because I spoke to them on the phone. And they didn't come back in stock in time, so I got the other element, and maybe the bit that I'm on about that's out of stock, I'll get you in the future.
Oh, the most handsome dog in the Cotswolds, arguably the south of England.
Yes, arguably the entire world.
I have been asked a number of times to star in fashion shows, but you know what? I'm not really up for that anymore. Those days are behind me.
No, I'm too intelligent for that, you know. Right, so... this is like a what I got.
I've got Dexy's tail wagging in the corner. The corner of the video, there's a little wag.
I love the colour of this
lovely
ribbon.
Chap.
This is very special.
I've got the TV in the background. Oh, we're going to watch a film tonight, aren't we? And then it's probably going to get wheeled out of here in time for Christmas.
VCA.
I haven't opened this, so I hope it is exactly what I ordered.
I love their boxes. I've never owned anything from this brand
before. No, I know, and I've heard you mention it, and obviously a friend of ours, Robin, has some beautiful jewellery from there, and I know you've said in the past, oh, well, I've already got this jewellery, but I just thought, you know, you can never have too much jewellery, fact.
Dun, 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 oh, darling.
The it's the necklace, though.
It's so beautiful.
So, I wanted to get you the earrings for Christmas and the necklace in the summer, really, because
well,
I know you said
I was actually thinking
that would work with the necklace, what you're wearing now.
Christmas time, like a necklace. Winter necklace.
Bit naff that there's plastic on it, isn't it? Careful, yeah. Be careful pulling it.
Well, should I put it on now or should I put it on after my shower? Because I have got a lot of fake tan on.
Maybe put it on after then.
I'll put it on
in that
after
case,
my
this is going all blurry again.
But even look how beautiful the chain is.
Well, hopefully it's nice.
That is such a classic.
And the thing is, we're very, very fortunate with this job, and you've worked with some amazing jewellery brands. Mm-hmm. However, the only net downside to that, and don't get me wrong, it's all positive in reality because we're very lucky, but the downside is, of course, that it means I often don't have the opportunity to buy you jewellery that then sort of has that special meaning behind it. So hopefully that is... So it's our 11th Christmas... I thought it was our 10th, so I kind of was thinking of it like that. But it's actually our 11th Christmas together. So, there you go.
So
well, it's actually a birthday gift, of course, but...
Thank you, darling. I even love the box.
Dexy, yeah, the box is nice.
It's absolutely beautiful. Very on brand with the sage green. And Dexy's here to say thank you as well. Thank you, darling.
Lovely,
I think
good.
It's safe to say that I and everyone that watches the videos have very much enjoyed the Christmas advent calendar.
Well, it was Dexy who did the clues. I did the clues, you see, Daddy. Look at that long snout.
Gorgeous and very generous,
so
thank you.
Good.
Had an epic delivery from Flowered, awesome. Including, of course, beautiful bouquet of flowers. And then this
game set.
It's not just chess, is it?
It's chess and draughts, this is,
oh,
I think.
Oh, clever.
Which is cute.
So can a draughts board also be a chess board?
Yes, yeah.
Very cool.
You're right, handsome.
This is really handy. We should play it over Christmas and then... Actually, do you know what? It's so lovely. That could live on the drawing room table. Or
definitely.
A straw top cottage.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Right, darling, I'll leave you to unpack that. I'll sort out the flowers and then I'm going to shower off my fake tan. And then it's time to get veg chopping, Chick-fil-A. And there we go. I have popped the lovely bouquet from Flowered up here next to the advent calendar. They look absolutely beautiful. And again, I've used one of the Daylesford glass nut jars that we had empty as the water container, because this actually has quite a few holes in the bottom. A lovely Christmas gift. Thank you from Flowered. Okay, chef, can we have an update? How are we getting on?
So, we are now... The stuffing is taking shape.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the sausage meat from our local butchers. And this is from their local farm, so that's the nice thing.
Very local.
The pork that our butchers sell is their own farm.
Mm.
Tamworth pork, so that's going in here to the sausage meat. And then that's
So every time someone sees Tamworth pork on the menu, does that mean it's come from our butcher?
I believe Tamworth is a breed of pig.
Ah.
Like saying Longhorn beef or something. But they have Tamworth pork, Tamworth pigs.
Right.
So then we're mixing this in. It's a little bit warm, but I think it should be fine. And basically, this is going to go into the turkey. And then it's also going to go into a small pan for some extra bits.
Lovely. Do you put breadcrumbs on it when it's the...
I'm following a new Jamie Oliver recipe as we speak.
Mm-hmm.
I believe breadcrumbs go in a minute, yeah.
Lovely.
But the chestnuts, and we've got apricots I went with. He's done dried apple, I think.
Mmm, a bit sweeter.
And then we put some cider. You know the cider you got from the newt?
The newt, wow. Lovely.
That's going in here.
Very nice.
So, it's looking good. A bit
very
messy.
Very nice.
But this is how you add real flavour to your turkey.
Absolutely. And then we've got, where did the Daylesford red wine end up? Is that in our lasagna?
That's in the ragu.
That's in the ragu. Lasagna. It's getting quite bubbly, is that okay?
Yeah, that's exactly fine, but I mean, it could do with a couple of stirs, maybe?
Okie dokie. Sous chef on the job. And this just bubbles away for an hour or so, right?
Even longer, I think.
Lovely. Okay, I'll go. They are now in the drawing room. We're going to have some drinks. It's that moment of calm after the madness. Charlie and I, and with everybody's help, we have been doing the final prep for the veg for tomorrow. The lasagna is about to be formed. I'm wearing my beautiful new necklace. It is just so, so gorgeous. I think we're just going to play some games in the drawing room. Charlie's got a few last minute bits to finish off, but everything's under control. Sprout dish ready for action tomorrow, hispy cabbage for tonight. Ragu is getting richer and tastier by the minute.
Charles is getting his face on a pound note.
Oh no, I chose the posher faces for the posher.
So £50, he's like, yeah. Oh, Dickie's £10. Yeah. Just chucked you away.
Yeah.
Totally confused.
Look, if you do behind the ear.
£100, Dexter, like.
Read the board.
And then £500, practically aristocracy.
read the board.
Oh, Joe, she got to read the board, apparently. Okay, let's have a look.
Just be careful with your drink.
Char, you've smashed
that. It didn't arrive and I was going to be gutted.
Oh my god.
That's
okay,
right.
So,
right.
Mayfair, let's see, is the coach house and the old rectory.
Oh, that's where the posh people live.
Wait. What does it say instead of go to jail?
Paddock Farm, that's controversial.
Well, no. So basically, the only challenge with this is, geographically, I wanted it to be accurate.
Okay, the power station is Western Power.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so the orange place is our Soho farmhouse,
yep.
Quince and Clover, and the yurt at Nicholson's. Instead of free parking, it's car charging. Over
at
the red department. You are so good at your geography.
He's good, isn't he?
The garden centre.
Oh, hang on, what A levels did you do?
Actually, not
I did geography by the
field. The Bell at Langford and Tyne.
Yes.
And then we've got all together in the yellow section Dalesford, the Wild Rabbit, and the Fox at Oddington.
I'm not going to be happy about
that. We need to sell this board because it's so much better than the actual one.
Actually, the only problem is it's quite expensive, so we wouldn't make very much.
It's not going to go to Banbury.
Yeah.
And then in the green section, we've got Josie's Greenhouse, the Presbytery, and the Chapel of Peter and Paul. Not St. George's, could you?
No, I didn't. Church. I just thought because it's. Yeah.
It's right next
Sorry,
door.
Did I miss it? What are the posh houses? I heard the coach house.
And the old rectory.
And the old rectory.
Okay.
They are the dark blue.
We've got it layers later.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
They
thought we'd
have
But have you done the chance cards?
Yeah, I have as well, yeah. But there's also some quite. Isn't there on here? Have you missed anything?
That's clever, how clever.
Oh yeah, here, so Dexter's investment fund. You land on Dexter's investment fund, you have to pay £100.
You should have put Dickie's Wardrobe.
No, there is.
Dickie's Wardrobe.
No, Dickie's new business venture. And there's also Dickie's business gets liquidated.
Because I'm not a very good businessman.
Oh my gosh, listen to the chance cards.
Yeah.
Community chest, you've won second prize in the marrow growing contest. From a sale of courgettes, collect £50. Dexter lends you £100.
It's your birthday.
You are very clever.
Oh no,
very
clever. Dickens company loan, pay £100. Income tax refund, gutter clearing repairs. Life insurance matures, collect £100.
Oh, I just love that one.
Yeah.
Dexter's Bitcoin investment matures.
Can you pass me that?
Dickens bankruptcy relief. £850.
Yeah, that's a huge one, by the way. I amended that.
I know.
I actually amended that, and I think we might have to play it and take it out if it starts destroying the game, because it's quite a lot of cash.
That's how the recession starts.
You are assessed for chimney repairs, pay £40 per house and £115 per hotel.
Oh.
Go to Banbury. Go directly to Banbury. Do not pass it. Get out of Banbury.
To be clear, we're just talking about property.
Banbury's
a good place to buy a house.
Oh, God. You sell your home for a bed at the village fair, collect £150.
Shit.
Advanced to Strawtop Cottage. Wait, where's that?
It's not there, is it?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it is.
Oh, yeah. Strawtop Cottage 1, Strawtop Cottage 2, and Strawtop Cottage 3.
Yeah, well, I just thought I'd use. Because also, I also thought I didn't know what the third one should be.
Scarlet. You've been elected chairman of Dexter's investment fund. Pay each payer £50. Tractor repairs. Pay each payer £15. Advanced to Tyne, Oxfordshire. You pass go.
So do you know what? So just wait. So you can't customise the pieces.
Oh,
so I went on Etsy and I did buy some vintage pieces.
make general repointing repairs on all of your property.
So these are more vintage ones. But do you know what? The dream ones were like a pig. a defender. I did try and search, but I actually ordered a few things, but they arrived and they were massive. Look, like this squirrel I ordered, but he was he's massive.
Thinking he was small.
He's too big.
Dickens banking error.
To play really.
Dickens banking error in your favour. I'd like £200.
Can I see Dickens' investment?
Oh my god.
Dickens does get
poor old Dickens.
He just
keeps hearing his name in chat. He doesn't have no idea.
Inspirational. And now I know at the Fairmont why you flipped open the Monopoly game.
No, that's me.
Yeah.
Oh, that was you, Jones.
Yeah.
Because at the Fairmont.
You know the story there is a Cotswold Monopoly, but unfortunately it's like sponsored by Diddley Squat.
Yeah.
And it's just entirely crap. Like there's nothing good in there. They've got like some of the really weird...
It's a little bit you have to hold, to hold up the shop, right?
No, that's what I mean. Oh, right, yeah, true. Yeah.
This is a new one.
Let's go outside, the snow is falling down and every child is having so much fun. The snowman is twice the size as me with a smile as quirky as mine. We're holding hands to keep each other warm while we stand and watch a choir perform and all the Christmas songs that we love. Yeah, all the Christmas songs that we love. And in a while we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate by the fire. Cause all I want is to spend this day with you. Let me give you a Christmas, a moment we'll fill with love and joy. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe's baby with you. I don't need any presents, as long as I spend this day with you. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe's baby with you. Woohoo! Making plans of what we're gonna do. I feel so blessed that I can be with you. Cause God knows that I've been longing for ya. I just wanna hold you close. You know the stars are shining just for you. Let's take a walk and we can follow the moonlight till we reach a place we can stay. Maybe kiss a bit and dream away. And in a while we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate.
Well, my darlings, we have just had our delicious lasagna for our now tradition of a Christmas Eve dinner. We have blended up the leftover garlic bread ready to be sprinkled on the cauliflower cheese tomorrow. Great idea. Picked up from the Dalesford Cookery School. And darlings, we are now just going to, as you can see, we've got our pyjamas on, we're just going to go down to the drawing room and I think we're going to watch a Christmas film all together in our pyjamas. So, I am going to bid you good night and say thank you so much for joining me for this incredible Vlogmas journey. It has been such a joy, truly such a joy to share our December with you, our Christmas with you. I'm so grateful for everyone that has watched, that has commented, that has given the video a thumbs up, that has subscribed to the channel. And I just want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. So darlings, I hope you've had the most wonderful day. Don't worry, I'll be back before too long. Gonna film a couple of little snippets of our Christmas and share that with you at some point over the next week or so. But darlings, for now, I really hope you've enjoyed Vlogmas 2022. And from myself and Charlie from Dexter and Dickens, good night and Merry Christmas.